Welcome to Feed Dump, where I'm Batman. Joining me this week is Commissioner Gordon.
I'm Gary Oldman.
And Bane.
I didn't actually get a chance to see the movie, so can I still play?
What? Okay, leave. Go see The Dark Knight Rises. We'll wait.
Fine.
What did you think?
Oh, I didn't actually go see it. I just went and got a snack.
Alright, well, we'll just do this anyway, because we don't have any time now, James. Thanks. And hopefully we'll find some criminal news stories to abuse. A Georgia woman has a fresh new mugshot for misusing the emergency call system after she dialed 911 to complain that a previous mugshot of hers was unflattering.
Why does she care if it's flattering or not? Is she planning on using it as her Facebook profile picture?
Ooh, that'd be a great idea. When you get a mugshot, it automatically replaces your Facebook photo. It would be a great deterrent. So, before she made this call to 911, did she, like, get her hair all done and get her makeup ready and everything, like, so she was ready for them to take the new photo when she got arrested from this call that she was making?
I don't think so, because the new photo is also pretty unflattering. That's the new photo.
You hear a lot about these, you know, frivolous 911 calls. I think there really needs to be, like, an awareness campaign put out there that 911 is not what you call if you just want to talk to the cops for any reason. Hello, sir. What is the nature of your emergency?
Hi.
Hi? Are you in some kind of trouble?
No, I just wanted to call and see how your day was going.
Oh, well, it's fine. Thank you very much.
That's very kind of you.
What are you wearing?
Meanwhile, in Pennsylvania, a mother faces up to 6 felony charges for accessing school records and changing her children's grades.
See, this just shows the ageism in our society. When Ferris Bueller does it, it's fun. When parent does it, it's very bad.
I believe the same could be said for anything Ferris Bueller does.
That's fair, actually.
Can I just say, best mom ever? I wish my mom was a hacker.
I actually like this. It's quite heartwarming, because obviously this mother knows a lot about her children's academic performance in that she knows that they weren't doing that well, right? It wasn't like the kids were like, oh no, I'm going to have to take back this F to my parents. The parents knew that they were having trouble and were doing what they could do to help. That was breaking into the school and changing the records, but still, the thought was there.
Apparently, she accessed these grades 110 times, changing things such as an F for her daughter to an M, meaning medical exemption, and changing one of her son's grades from a 98 to a 99.
So a 98 was already really good, and she wanted to make it even better, but 100 would be too obvious. Hey, wasn't this an F?
No, M for medical. Yes, medical reasons. She couldn't do it for medical reasons.
What, sucking at math is a medical reason now?
Because this is 6 felony charges, the upper end of the sentence she could be facing is 42 years and $90,000.
Ironically, if she'd just given the $90,000 to the school in the first place, they could have hired better teachers, had better textbooks, better equipment. Maybe she wouldn't have had to change the grade.
90 grand? I don't know. That's just bribing money right there.
Congratulations, your son got 98%.
98?
Yeah.
You sure you don't mean 99?
Nope. No, it's definitely 98.
I don't know, because I think my son's being after-school tutored by my friend here, Ben Franklin.
Are you trying to bribe me?
Absolutely, yes I am.
Okay, good. Just wanted to make sure.
Okay, cool.
We're on the same page. Sweet. Excellent.
A woman in Newfoundland had to call the police after she discovered a drunk man passed out on the couch in her house, who refused to leave. He is now being charged with what?
Well, whatever he's doing has got to start with breaking and entering, because before that, he's not actually in the house.
How about failure to remove self from sofa?
Loitering?
Grand theft my spot on the couch?
Being drunk and orderly, because he was sleeping, which is not really disorderly. How about lethargy in the first degree?
I don't know, arson, murder, assault? You haven't really told us the whole story, Graham.
Yeah, that's a good point. He could have done all sorts of stuff after he woke up on the couch.
Exactly.
The wording of the charge being leveled against this man is unlawfully being in a dwelling.
Okay, I've got a really good idea.
All right,
so you invite everybody you hate to a party.
I'm not liking this so far.
Okay, but you gotta stick with it, okay? So, you tell everybody that they need to be out of the house by midnight. When everybody shows up, you go around your house and set all the clocks back by an hour. And then when midnight rolls around, they think it's 11 o'clock, the cops show up and they arrest all their stupid sorry asses.
This week in Copenhagen marks the 55th annual World Santa Congress, where Santas from all over the world meet to hang out and, according to this article, do some Zumba fitness classes, among other things.
Does anybody else, when you hear World Santa Congress, imagine, like, a whole bunch of Santas sitting around in, like, a dark room? It's like, all right, Santas, we need to discuss naughty and nice. Some of you have been too lenient. Gentlemen, I propose economic sanctions against Timmy Jenkins in the fifth grade. He's a big dick.
Oh my god, I'm so excited. First in line. Oh my god.
I think you need more than just a hat to be Santa.
Yeah, well, you're not Gary Oldman.
No, wait, Mr. Oldman, come back! James, you scared Gary Oldman away. Well, until next time, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat. They can have it if they want it. I'm still Batman.
Yeah, I think you have to, like, tell them that you want them to leave.
Really?
Like, when you want... Well, like, if you phone 911... And after you're done with the pleasantries, as we talked about,
yes.
Then probably the first thing they're going to ask you is, did you ask them to leave?